Inni kolgrun. Many men have gone. Lay me down in the cauldron. Wherefore many men have gone. When they come, I will stand my ground, stand my ground. I'll never be afraid.
And Apache attack helicopters move forward. Twice they tried to resupply British troops at Sangin and failed. It seemed like third time lucky. But lucky's not the word for it. Gunners fired as the four helicopters approached Britain's most exposed military base in Afghanistan. This gunfire was nothing to what followed. There had been warnings of a Taliban threat to helicopters, so British troops were ready in strength at the landing spot. But as dawn broke, the Taliban were ready too. They were hidden near the helicopters. And as we landed, they prepared to launch their ambush. It came seconds after we hit the ground. The troops retaliate with massive firepower, light tanks and dozens of men raining ammunition on the Taliban. Afghan troops firing rocket-propelled grenades. Taliban too fire RPGs. They fly just over our heads. The troops catch glimpses of the Taliban, between 5 and 10 fighters. The gunfire is intense from all directions. Heavy machine guns and tanks outgunning the Taliban. Above, the attack helicopters open fire repeatedly. It all lasts half an hour before the troops make it back to the base.
It's obviously unlike anything I've ever experienced or could have imagined before we left the UK.
No British base has come under attack more often than this one, and it's just been attacked again with rocket-propelled grenades fired by the Taliban, and the troops are now firing back with heavy machine guns and with mortars of their own. This has been going on for about 5 minutes now, the firing becoming quite intense.
This is a base under daily fire, but giving no ground. This is Bill Neely for NBC News, Sangin, southern Afghanistan.
First to be brought off the aircraft, Guardsman Daniel Probin, who came from the West Midlands. He was 22 years old and a member of the Grenadier Guards. He was killed by an explosive device while on patrol in Helmand province in Afghanistan. His platoon commander said he was, without question, one of the very best soldiers in the company. Lance Corporal Andrew Thomas said, "Danny was a friend you could always rely on. He was like a brother." It was during the same incident that Corporal Darren Bonner was killed, a 31-year-old from served in the 1st Battalion of the Royal Anglian Regiment. He was a keen weightlifter and had a big personality to go with it. He was also a devout Christian. Darren had been in the army for 14 years and previously served in Northern Ireland, Iraq and the Balkans. His company commander said he was a dedicated young man who was genuinely striving to make a difference. Wayne Cole said, "Daz Bonner was a colourful character, larger than life,